last time on the world's weirdest singing show. Wildcard Microphone sang their way into the competition.
That is exactly what I'm talking about.
But it was Zombie who went back to the dead.
Take it off!
It is number one, kids!
Tonight.
I feel like I've heard this voice before.
Another brand new Wildcard Mask takes to the stage.
I'm buying a bigger garden
to blow this competition apart.
This has never happened on The Masked Singer.
I loved it.
And one celebrity will be...
This panel tonight is on fire.
Unmasked.
Take it off!
Oh, my goodness!
Get ready to play TV's wildest guessing game.
Thank you for being a part of this show, which is, I don't know how do you describe it. Imagine the weirdest dream you've ever had multiplied by 1,000, and then imagine that the monster that's chasing you in your dream is a gigantic rooster wearing a tweed suit. Yeah. Which would be terrifying if you didn't have such a lovely voice. Tonight, you will see four superb singers, four amazing masks, but you will not see the famous faces behind those masks until the end of the show, because we will then see one secret celebrity's face right here on this stage tonight. And guiding our guesses along the way, this fantastic foursome, it's got to be Mel B!
Yeah!
It can only be Abby Chatfield. Ooh. It has to be Dave Hughes. And it must be Christy Swan. Abby, we're more than halfway through this series.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to ask, how are you feeling about the captaincy situation?
Hughesy is our self-appointed captain, everyone.
Everyone's happy about that, aren't they?
No. No.
Don't woo. Now, here's the thing. Chrissy Swan has guessed two masks correctly so far.
This is true.
And I was thinking after the last mask that we saw, Beautiful, Amazing Zombie, that maybe it's time to shake things up in the hierarchy.
Yes.
And maybe it becomes a matriarch rather than a patriarch. And that person maybe is the swan herself.
Yeah, I'm down.
Mel and I discussed this.
Yeah.
Hashtag mask spill.
There is a spill
it's a
going
spill.
On.
It's a coup.
But whoever said this was a democracy, all right? So, all right, if Chrissy gets it right tonight, I will abdicate. If she gets the winner tonight, she becomes team captain.
We have high stakes. I'm up for the challenge, though, Hughesy.
Chrissy, if you do become captain, I do have to ask this. You're a very busy person. You have breakfast radio, you have TV commitments, you have a whole family, your kids.
Mm-hmm.
How are you managing the mental load of all this guessing as well?
I'm neglecting everything apart from the Masked Singer. This has just got its fangs in me. I can't sleep properly. I'm dreaming of the masks. I've actually had a dream about tonight's show. Stay tuned.
Mel, last time we stood here, we had our very first wild card. I've just been told we've got another one tonight.
Yes. I love the wild card.
A brand new mask. We've never seen it before.
Yes. Freshie. You see, this just makes me want to lose my shiznot over and over and over again. The wild card is so exciting. So we get really excited about it.
I get a fresh chance to get it wrong. I can't wait.
Yes, right. Exactly.
Always the optimist, Hughesy. I love it. That wild card will join us later in the show, but we're going to kick off with a triple treat, a three-mask collaboration. Make some noise for the incredible voices of Snapdragon, Rooster and Popcorn!
Oh, this is going to be unbelievable!
Love is in the air.
Everywhere I look around. Love is in the air. Every sight and every sound.
And I don't know if I'm being foolish. I don't know if I'm being wise. But it's something that I must believe in. And it's there when I look in your eyes. Love is in the air, in the whisper of the tree. Oh, love is in the air, in the thunder of the sea. And I don't know if I'm just dreaming.
Nice harmony.
Don't know if I feel safe. But it's something that I must believe in. And it's there when you call out my name.
Come on.
There's so much show business. Mel B, how was it for you?
I loved it. Come on now. I just want to see them all again.
Oh, we're gagging for it up here. There are three superstars on that stage, and I cannot wait to find out who they are.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
Chrissy, I mean, I don't know if you've had something to do with the playlist, but there seems to be a lot of Chrissy Swan's greatest driving songs going on.
It really feels like it. Another Aussie classic from John Paul Young. I mean, who doesn't love that song?
Yes!
Fantastic.
Sung to you by a chicken, a flower and a snack.
It's the best combination.
Ever.
Ever.
So our second wild card is prepped, warmed up, ready to go. I've never seen them before. Are you ready?
Yes!
Australia, meet No!
That is a big boy.
Is that one of the biggest masks ever?
Nice to see you. Oh, we're going to cuddle.
Aww.
No, ladies and gentlemen. Before this mighty mask sings for us, shall we head down the garden path and check out some clues about Gnome?
Here we go.
Hi, I'm Gnome, and I'm bringing the magic to this competition.
He's slapping his thigh. Maybe he's German.
I do love a green and pleasant land.
Green land, I'm thinking tennis.
But I'm more of a city now. It is my garden of earthly delights. This is where you will find my desires. Not every gnome gets involved in politics.
Croatian flag. Croatian.
But I do know a lot about preferential voting.
What's he holding?
Is he holding awards?
What sort of awards?
Don't confuse me with a goblin. We only have the name in common. And it makes me double boiling mad. Tonight, the gnome is coming on hot.
Hot gnome.
the Wolves?
I think they were Logies. I've never been real close to one, but I reckon they were. Well, if it's three Logies, it could be Rove.
Oh, it could be Naughty Rove.
Rove is not 8 foot tall, but he's more garden gnome size.
It's your mate.
Well, if it's under there, I'm sorry, man.
Gnome sinks wrist next on the Masked Singer. The gnome of entertainment. Our wild card is next. First time they're on stage, but honestly, they've been singing since they were in the nursery. Give it up for gnome.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales. Meant for someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me, and that's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunting all my dreams. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace or doubt in my mind. I'm in love. A given thing. Seems the more I gave, the less I got. What's the use in trying?
I know who that is.
When
I know who it is.
Really?
Yep.
When I need sunshine, I got rain.
Yes, I know.
Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried.
Yes! 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 No, ladies and gentlemen! The Gnome! Gnome, you are... You're an ornament to this show, mate. You really are. That was fantastic. Dave,
I'm a believer.
Yeah.
Oh, mate, I'm buying a bigger garden because I need you in it, gnome, all right? And I want you to take the other four gnomes with you because I think the Spice Girls might have a revival situation going on.
Did the clues tell you anything? Do you have any ideas? Did the voice tell you anything?
I'm weighing it up between Jimmy Barnes and Goran Ivanisevic.
Goran Ivanisevic. Oh.
Goran Ivanisevic, if you don't know, you need to study your tennis history, who won Wimbledon against Pat Rafter back in 2001. And this gnome is here to take another Aussie title home, I reckon.
Yeah.
And he also, green grass is one of the clues. He won on Wimbledon. He was a hothead. There was a double boil. Wasn't there a double boil
double
situation?
Double boiler, yes, double boiler.
Goran was one of the biggest boil-over guys in the game. Ah. So, yeah.
Good work, Husey.
Thank you.
Well done, Husey.
I want to keep my captaincy.
Try to hold on to that captaincy for all you've got. Mel, there it was, a gnome singing about being a believer. How was it for you?
It was fun, actually. You know what? What mesmerises me is how tall you must be. Regardless of how tall the outfit is, you are moving quite swift and quick. So I'm thinking you really are that tall. And you sung like an athlete would sing to me.
Yes.
Is that a nice way of saying you're not a professional singer?
No. Yes. So, I mean, there's a few clues that make sense to me. He said, I do love a green and pleasant land. I have something that you might be really impressed with.
The Sydney Swans.
This person has played on the green AFL field since he was 17 years old.
Yes, yes.
Do you know who I'm getting at?
Yeah, the legend himself.
Do you want to say it with
the
me?
The one and only, Bonnie Franklin!
I like this.
That is a big guess. That would be...
And he's a big guy, and he can handle that gnome costume.
Well and surely could. Abby, Now, that song, it spans generations, that song. So to hear that sung to you by a gigantic gnome, what was that like?
Oh, it was beautiful. It was like I was at Shrek the Musical, but better. It was stunning. I have a few guesses.
Yes.
Good.
Now, they're all a bit loosey-goosey, but that's all right. We're starting off with a wild card. Now, Nomi, you mentioned preferential voting. And I thought, what shows involve preferential voting?
What ones?
Well, the biggest preferential vote of all is The Bachelor. You've listed them on your sheet one by one.
Ooh. But Osher's there.
Could this be Tim Robards?
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Chrissy, who is behind the mask?
Well, I think it's time for me to divulge my dream.
Oh, this is unbelievable.
Who is it?
What is it?
Who and it wasn't it? Here on set, but my dreams generally mean something. And featured in the dream quite heavily was Matt Preston.
Ah. You could hide a cravat under that beard pretty easily.
There was a hot reference there. The theme song from MasterChef is Hot and Cold by Katy Perry. There was a newspaper. Matt Preston is a very well-regarded journalist. But here's the clincher, guys.
Oh, here we go. This is for the trifecta of correct guesses.
Cravats originate in Croatia.
Oh!
That is a good one.
Has she done it again?
That's a good one.
Our panel thought that one of these celebrities might be behind the mask. Who do you think it is?
Absolutely nothing is going to stop us from seeing a celebrity face right here on this stage tonight. Could be you. This is the Masked Singer. This is the Masked Singer. A fact which actually bears repeating. This is the Masked Singer. If you're a florist, prepare yourself. You're about to see the best singing statement you'll ever lay your eyes on in this time slot. Dig your teeth into these clues about Snapdragon. Come on.
Yes, I love Snapdragon.
I'm Snapdragon, and I'm in my element in The Masked Singer. Although, I might feel like a babushka doll. As a Snapdragon, you never know what you'll be asked to do.
That's four Snapdragons. I wonder if Snappy was in a band.
One day, the public showers you with love. And the next, you're heading for a downfall. Ow.
Are they clam shells? Are they oyster shells? Shell downfall.
Snapdragons come in all colors of the rainbow. My childhood was quite golden.
Definitely from a privileged background.
I'm Snapdragon, and I'm a natural to win the Masked Singer.
I know this is going to blow my mind again.
I'm not your friend. Or anything, damn. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am. I'm not your friend. Or anything, damn. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am. Ha, stop. Ha, what the hell are you talking about? Ha, get my pretty name out of your mouth. Well, you're not the same with or without. Don't talk about me like how you might know how it feels. Top of the world, but your world isn't real. Oh, I'm sorry. Huh. I don't think I caught your name. Huh. I don't think I caught your name. Your friend, or anything, damn. You think that you're the man.
incredible.
Snapdragon! What an unbelievable voice! Snapdragon! I am gobsmacked with the notes that come out of this flower. Chrissy, that was spectacular.
Snappy, you nailed that single note, and you are fast becoming my favourite in this competition. You are a miracle.
So good. So amazing.
So good.
That voice, did it tell you anything, who this might be?
Yes, I think I've got some ideas. I've got a new guess.
Whoa.
A fresh guess.
A freshie from Swan.
Mika. Oh, that's a good one. Yeah.
That is a good one.
I knew you'd love that, Mel. And the reason I think it might be Mika is, A, the voice. I think the babushka reference could refer to the fact that Mika was trained by a Russian opera singer.
Oh.
And, you know, if that's true, then my gosh, you can hear that.
Yeah, good one.
And the golden childhood could be referring to his hit song, We Are Golden.
Really good.
So there's
two
solid guesses.
There's definitely something there.
That's a captain's pick right there. Mel B, that voice, come on.
I mean, I feel like I've heard this voice before. I mean, you can really sing. I mean, really sing. And you just hold your own. I mean, you just look like it's just nothing for you. 100% a professional singer. Because every time we've seen you, your voice is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So, I mean, oh, God, where do you start with the amazing singers of the whole entire universe? Mm.
Every journey starts with one terrible guess, all right? So.
Well, no, I did agree with you about the Sam Smith.
Yes.
But I texted Sam Smith and it's definitely not Sam Smith. Definitely not.
Oh, that hurts me.
And then I thought Adam Lambert.
Oh!
Because I know Adam, he did start his career. This is where the seashells thing, you know, when they were coming down on the head.
Yes, what was that?
He did start his career on a cruise ship. Cruise ship, water.
That's good.
Dave, you've heard that incredible voice. Who does it make you think of?
Adam Lambert is a really good guess, I believe.
But
Sam Smith is still on my radar, and we've got to know that I was the first person to say that, right? So that's the...
Why wouldn't we not believe that?
Because often I am wrong.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm going to do from now on? I'm just going to put out names that it isn't.
That's good.
And that's different from every other season, how?
All right, you're brilliant, whoever you are.
Abby?
It's kind of giving Sam Smith, but it's vibes and response, emotional goosebumps only. Callum Scott.
Oh!
Let me tell you why. There was reference to I'm dancing with other Snapdragons. One of Callum Scott's first songs that he released was that cover of Dancing on My Own, one of
the best songs of all time.
See, that is a really good one. That is a really good one. It really is.
Our panel thought that one of these celebrities might be behind the mask. Who do you think it is? Who is that?
Yes!
Only two songs to go, and then the lid comes off for one very secret celebrity. We are going to see the actual face tonight. I can't wait, you can't wait, they can't wait.
This
is the Masked Singer! Super secret celebrities, see if they can sing silly songs, staying secreted under silk, silicon and Swarovskis by the seashore.
Yes! That was good.
Of all the masks here tonight, if at the end of this show, Rooster's head comes off, he's just going to keep running around the stage like nothing happened. Stick around with these clues to see if we can't figure out Rooster.
Right, let's do it, guys. Come on.
Here we go.
As a rooster, I never want to be a bore. I want to entertain. Whether it's putting boot to leather or plucking on a G-string.
A G-string, a G-banger, if you will.
I love New York.
Who doesn't?
If you can make it there, you can also make it anywhere. Even Alice Springs.
New York and Alice Springs? Is it Crocodile Dundee?
If you move around as much as I do, I'd like to say welcome to wherever you are. Sometimes you just don't measure up. All I know is that I did it my way.
That's disco queen Gloria Gaynor. She sung I Will Survive.
I'm Rooster. And in this competition, it's all about me.
All about me. That rings a bell.
Myself.
I love this song.
A real good time. I feel alive. And the world turning inside out.
Wow, good stuff.
I'm floating about in ecstasy.
Ooh.
So don't stop me now. Cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger. I'm defying the laws of gravity. I'm the racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I wanna go, go, go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning to the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. Traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man out of you. Come on! Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball. Don't stop me now. Everyone have a good time. Give me a call. Don't stop me now. Cause I'm having a good time. Don't stop me.
So good. Rooster!
I love him.
Rooster! That was fantastic. Amazing. Once again for Rooster!
Yeah. Yes!
A classic, Mel. A classic song sung by a giant chicken.
Oh, I know. Where do I even start? I just loved it. I loved it. I loved it. I loved it. You know what? You're so much fun. You've got, like, the quirkiest sense of humour. You completely stay in character. And, by the way, that song was pitch perfect. Absolutely pitch perfect.
Yes, yes.
So you're a singer, but you're a fun singer.
Yes.
This is brilliant.
What's lining up for you, Mel?
So this person used to want to be a professional runner before they ended up singing.
Wow.
And then when they started to sing, they were part of a boy band, but then they went solo. This person loves Australia, got lots of kids, has actually married an Aussie.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Ronan Keating.
Oh!
Married to an Aussie.
Come on!
I love him.
Really good.
Abby. Yeah. That song, like, one of the best ever.
Of all time.
What was it like for you?
That was so exhilarating. Such a dynamic performer. It's definitely someone who's done theatre or is a singer, but I think it's someone who's more, you know, multifaceted than just a singer. They have a song called All About Me, and that was said in as the last line in the clues package.
Yeah. Yes, it's all about me.
There was Gloria Gaynor, who sung I Will Survive.
Yes.
And, you know, who hosted a show called I Will Survive. Hugh Sheridan.
Hugh Sheridan.
Hugh Sheridan can sing.
Yes.
Brilliant guess, Abby.
That's a good one.
Brilliant, brilliant guess.
Thank you.
Hugh
Thank
is
you.
Amazing. This panel tonight is on fire.
Hughie, that's like two really, really strong guesses. How are you going to back it up, man?
I love Rooster. Fantastic. But Rooster is funny.
Yes,
really
yeah.
funny.
Yes.
Is this a professional comedian?
Great angle.
I think this could be a friend of mine. There was an AFL football there, remember that?
Yes, yes. yes.
This friend of mine is absolutely obsessed with the AFL. He's a really, really funny man. Mick Malloy.
All right. We'll give you that. We'll give you that.
Chrissy Swan.
I think the Rooster might be our Grammy Award winner.
Come on, who?
The name
Macklemore.
Oh, yeah.
Macklemore.
Yeah. I love that.
I don't know where it came from. It just came to me on a midnight clear.
And he got his costume at the thrift shop.
Correct. Yeah. Now, there was a reference to the Outback. His first daughter's middle name is Koala.
Oh, what?
Really?
What are the odds? Oh. I know.
Well, they hang out in the Outback.
There's more. Do. He's 1.8 metres tall. Rooster, you are a big, yes, juicy unit. No doubt about that.
Yeah. I love your vibe. I love that.
You like
I
it?
I really love it.
Could
I
be.
Honestly love it. I
Why
love
not?
That. Why not Macklemore?
Our panel thought that one of these celebrities might be behind the mask. Who do you think it is? Who is that?
Very, very soon, a mask will go up and the veil of mystery will drop on one very famous singer. Do you have a name? Tell anyone who'll listen, or no one will believe that you knew it all along. After the break, a very tasty treat indeed. Popcorn sings next here on The Masked Singer.
Go beyond the show with extended celebrity reveals, panellist interviews and more at 10play.com.au/TheMaskedSinger.
This is The Masked Singer. Four seasons in and I still feel like I'm living in a parallel universe. You know, the one where I don't have to whisper all the time. Last time we heard this singer, we learned that Dave Hughes is definitely down with OPP, other people's popcorn. Ooh, grab a handful of these clues about popcorn.
Let's go. All right, popcorn, who are you?
Am I spiritual? A lot of my class are, but don't think I'm a clean skin. I use a lot of ink.
Who's that?
That's Patrick Stewart.
I started young. Well, younger than most, but not my hero.
Started young, in showbiz or sport?
That's when I went from being a Malteser to popcorn. The people of Europe love popcorn. Northern Europe especially. Even if it makes them a bit phlegm-ish.
Red and white flag. That's Polish.
I'm popcorn. And I'll get salty if I don't win this competition.
That's a great voice.
It's a human sign.
I love this song.
When things go wrong, when the scent of it lingers and temptation strong, cold, cold heart, hardened by you. Some things looking better, baby, just passing.
What a solid servant of popcorn, Abby. Abby, that was something else, wasn't it?
It was great. I love hearing your voice. I love the performances, but I hate your clues. Oh. And I'm sick of hearing the voice. I'm like, the talking voice, it drives me insane. I have no idea what's going on.
There's always one mask that just stumps each of us. For me, it's Rooster. For you, it's Popcorn.
It's Popcorn. Now, yeah. I've got something.
Yeah.
Go on.
So, this person was nominated to be the Best Australian Act at the MTV Awards, the European MTV Awards.
Right.
Which is the clue about Europe loving popcorn.
Who is it?
I think it's Dean Lewis.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
Big guess from Abby Chatfield there. Cusey? You've just got a head full of corn kernels.
I do, absolutely. The Flemish clue got me.
Yep. Go on.
That is Dutch.
Yes. Mm. Yes.
Flemish is Dutch.
Yeah.
Yes. The salty clue confirmed it.
Oh.
Because this person is the Dutch dolphin champion swimmer, Peter van den Hoogenberg.
So many syllables.
Well, another one of the great names.
Chrissy Swan.
I don't believe that it is.
Oh, no.
I don't believe my dream is going to come true this season.
Never give up on your dreams.
Oh. I don't believe that's Rick Springfield in there. But guess who I think is in there? And
who?
That performance ticked every box for me. I think that is multiple Grammy Award winner.
Oh.
Will I Am. The very first clue we got about popcorn was, let me spell it out for you.
Yeah.
Will I Am.
Yeah.
This is huge.
He worked with Kylie Minogue. He's collaborated with Lady Gaga. Oh. And Patrick Stewart.
What?
Why is he there?
This is the mic drop.
I'm going to stand up to say it.
This is popcorn time.
Both Patrick Stewart and Will I Am were in the X-Men. That's very good.
Chrissy Swan, I've got a feeling that tonight's going to be a good night if you're right.
Yes!
What have you got, Mel?
So the clue was, I started young. Now, this was the youngest person to win Breakthrough Artist at the ARIA Awards at 14.
Ooh.
Right? He's got, like, 1.3 million followers on Instagram. He's
okay.
Very current, very, like, in the niche. He's about to explode. Who is he?
Who is it?
His dad's Dutch also. I just want to throw
that. Oh! His dad's Dutch!
Ruel.
Yeah!
Ruel's
you,
a good
one. You
know
Ruel is?
Of course I know Ruel.
You know, I take that back. If you know who Ruel is, you can stay team captain.
Quick, Google Ruel.
Our panel thought that one of these celebrities might be behind the mask. Who do you think it is? Who is that?
All of those celebrity names just floating out there in the ether. Don't be afraid, reach out, grab one. Commit, because you're running out of time. Guessing panel, studio audience, I need you to vote right now. Vote for your favourite performance of the night. The three singers with the most votes will sing another day, but the singer with the fewest votes, well, their elaborate game of hide and seek is over. They will have to show us who is behind the mask tonight. The MIBs are counting the votes right now. I'm going to show you they do not make any mistakes. When we return as a country, we will join hands, form a very large circle, and together scream, take it off over and over again. That's next, here on The Masked Singer. Who is that?
Who is that?
This is The Masked Singer, and these four incredible performances are actually four super secret, very famous celebrities, and we are about to discover the secret identity of one of them. The votes have been counted, and the result is in. The first mask that is safe to sing another day is... Rooster! Yes. The second mask, safe to sing, Another Day is.
Wonderful.
So it's come down to this. Gnome, come this way. Popcorn, come this way. And the celebrity who must now take it off is...
My heart is breaking. I'm gonna cry.
Sing one song, you came here for one night, and we're about to see who you really are. This has never happened ever on The Masked Singer. Guessing panel, I'm gonna give you one last chance. Who's behind this mask, Mel B?
I'm gonna go with Buddy Franklin.
Wow, Buddy Franklin, superstar.
It is.
Abby?
I think this is Tim Robards.
Hey.
Husey, lock in a name, mate.
I think it is Croatian Wimbledon winning champion Goran Ivanišević.
Okay, Chrissy, this is it. You've done pretty well so far, Chrissy.
Started with a dream last night about the dishy Matt Preston. And then I heard that voice and I thought, yeah, it could be him, it could be him. And then I did a little bit of looking around the clues and now I'm 100% sure that is Matt Preston.
Oh, that is a good one.
Well, that is what our panel think. What about you? Are you right?
Yes.
You're about to find out. Are you ready? Chef, I don't know how many best-selling books. There he is right there, Matt Preston!
Legend.
The king of the cravat!
I dreamt of you last night and now I'm looking at you. Can you believe it?
You are psychic, Chrissy. You always have been. The moment I heard you were judging, I knew I was in real trouble. There's no way I was going to get past you.
What made you want to come and do this? Why did you come and do Masked Singer, Matt?
Because it's so totally wrong. It's an area I have no skill in dancing, no skill in singing. It was one of those moments you just go, OK, I have to do this. I have to do this.
Matt, can I ask, at the start of the show, Dave was our captain, and then we said that if Chrissy guessed it, she would be our captain now. Do you think Chrissy should be our new team captain?
So I reckon, I mean, let's face it, well, you want the captain to be the guy that goes down with the ship, so I'd leave Dave as the captain.
Leave me as captain.
Thank you.
Perfect.
The team is still working.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. The amazing Matt Preston has raced our stage. Keep it going for the guessing panel. Mel B, Abby Chatfield, Dave Hughes and Chrissy Swan. You are too good at this, Chrissy Swan. Next time we meet Australia, drop your buffs, it's the merge. Every one of our remaining singers comes together on stage to sing on the same show. It's going to be so good. Take us out, the one, the only, the great, the powerful, Matt Preston. Good night, Australia. Yeah.
Come on.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales. Meant for someone else, but not for me.
Oh, yeah.
Love was out to get me.
disappointment haunting all my dreams. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love.